Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to my class. In this class, we are going to discuss about particle nature of electromagnetic radiations. In the last class, we discussed about wave nature of electromagnetic radiations and we solved some problems based on frequency, wavelength and wave number. Now, in this class, the topic is particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. Yes. Particle nature. To understand the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation, we have to know some concepts. As on the screen now, you can see the heading, particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. Here, some points are given. The first point is, the nature of emission of radiations from hot bodies. So first we have to understand the nature of emission of radiations from hot bodies. And the second point, ejection of electrons from the metal surface when radiation is striking on the metal surface. And the third one, variation of heat capacities of a solid as a function of temperature. So we have to understand all these concepts, then only we can understand the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. So first one is nature of emission of radiation from hot bodies. The second one, ejection of electrons from metal surface when radiation is striking on the metal surface. The third one, variation of heat capacities of a solid as a function of temperature. And we have to understand one more point. The point is here. So what we have to understand is the fourth point, line spectra of atoms with special reference to hydrogen. So all these are the phenomena. They are explained with the help of discrete amounts of energies are going to be liberated. Discrete amounts of energies. So we have to know about what is discrete amounts of energies. So to know all about these, first we are going to the first point. The first point, what is the first point mentioned? The nature of emission of radiation from hot bodies. The nature of radiation from hot bodies. Right, coming to the hot body. Yes, see me. Suppose in my hand, all of you know this is a duster. Now I am considering this duster as a hot body. For example, coffee glass. Suppose if it is considered as a coffee glass and this coffee glass is containing some hot coffee. After some time, what you will observe? If it is considered as a cup of hot coffee, after some time, what you will observe? If you are not going to drink, after some time, what you will observe? Is my question understand to you? Yes, the temperature is reduced. Correct. Temperature is reduced. Very good. Hot coffee turns into cold. Very good. It will cool down. Very good. Temperature goes down. Correct. Yes, all these are the phenomena happening. Is I am recording? Yes, yes, very good. So once again, how it is considered? It is considered as a hot body. So hot body is going to emit some heat. Once again, the hot body is going to emit some heat, nothing but radiation. So everywhere when a hot body is considered, the hot body is going to emit some radiations. The emitted radiations are having some energy. And the emitted radiations, actually we know radiations are having wave nature. Waves are having three characters, wavelength, frequency, and wave number. Once again, when a hot body is going to emit some radiations, hot heat in the form of waves, that emitted waves are having wavelength, frequency, and wave number. Yes, tell me, what is the relation between wavelength and frequency? What is the relation between wavelength and frequency? what is the relation between wavelength and frequency? Wavelength is represented by lambda. Frequency is represented by nu. And we know the relation. What we know the relation? Wavelength, lambda. Wavelength, lambda, is inversely proportional to. Wavelength, lambda, is inversely proportional to frequency. So all of us know the wavelength of any electromagnetic radiation is inversely proportional to frequency of electromagnetic radiation. Now, we are considering a hard body. We are considering a hard body. And the hard body is going to emit some radiations. And the emitted radiations are emitted in the form of waves, and the waves are having emitted radiations are having some wavelengths. Wavelengths are represented by lambda, and the emitted radiations are having some intensity of radiation. So we are going to give the relation between intensity of radiation versus wavelength of radiation of emitted radiations of hard body. So to understand the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation, first we are going to consider the relation between intensity of radiation versus wavelength of emitted radiations of hard bodies are going to be considered. Right, on the screen you are going to see one graph regarding hard bodies. On the screen you are going to see one graph. Yes, wait a minute, I will open that graph. My dear students, if you are having the NCERT textbook, in that NCERT textbook you can find this graph. Yes, this is the graph regarding the hard body radiations. And the graph, if you observe that graph, on the x-axis, wavelength of emitted radiations is taken. And the wavelength is measured in nanometers. On the y-axis, intensity of radiation is taken. So for a hard body, we are considering intensity of radiation that is taken on y-axis, wavelength of emitted radiation in the nanometers is taken on x-axis, and the hard body is taken at two different temperatures. Here, the hard body is considered at two different temperatures. See here, same hard body. Suppose if a cup of hot coffee, if a cup of hot coffee is taken at a temperature of, -35°C, the temperature is taken as T1, and the same cup of hot coffee, is taken at a temperature of 45°C, and the temperature is taken as T2. So what is considered here? A cup of hot coffee is considered. That cup of hot coffee is taken as a system. Once again, the cup of hot coffee is taken as a system. That is, a system is taken at temperature T1, and the same system is taken at temperature T2. Then we are going to give the relation between, intensity of radiation versus wavelength of radiation. Then we can observe two graphs. Here you can see the two graphs on the screen. Yes. First of all, you are seeing the first graph. In this graph, first the hot body is taken at T1 temperature. The hot body is taken at T1 temperature. See this blue color curve. Just observe only the blue color curve. So if you observe the blue color curve, what you can understand? On the x-axis, wavelength is going to be increased. 100,000 nanometers, 2000 nanometers, 3000 nanometers. On the x-axis, wavelength is going to be increased. Whenever the wavelength of emitted radiations, when the wavelength of emitted radiation increases, what is happening? Intensity of radiation is also increasing. See this one? This is the intensity of radiation increasing. The intensity of radiation is increasing, reaching to a maximum point, and then the intensity of radiation slowly decreases. So this was observed by the scientist Max Planck. So the experiment was done by Max Planck. He observed that whenever a hot body is taken at a temperature of T1, and the hot body is going to emit the radiation, the emitted radiations are having wavelengths. So when the wavelength of emitted radiation is increasing, 1000 nanometers to 2000 nanometers, 2000 nanometers to 3000 nanometers. So what is happening here? The wavelength of emitted radiations is going to increase. As a result, the intensity of emitted radiation is increasing, reaching to a maximum point and then decrease. So this was the first observation made by James Maxwell. And secondly, the same hot body now taken at a temperature of T2. The same hot body is taken at a temperature of T2. Again, he observed that when the wavelength of emitted radiations are going to increase, when the wavelength of emitted radiations are going to increase, 1000 nanometers to 2000 nanometers, 2000 nanometers to 3000 nanometers. What is happening here? Wavelength of emitted radiations is going to increase for a hot body. Then what he observed? This is observation. The intensity of emitted radiations, the intensity of emitted radiations increases, reaches to a maximum point, and then the intensity of emitted radiations decreases. So this is the observation made by Maxwell. The scientist's name is Maxwell. He observed the relation between, what he observed? Maxwell observed the relation between intensity of emitted radiations versus wavelength of emitted radiations of a hot body. From this one, what we can understand? From these two graphs, what we can understand? Yes, my dear students, just forget this topic for a little bit time. Just simply observe. Suppose if it is a hot body, if it is a hot body, and just wait a minute. Yes, it is convenient now. Suppose if it is a hot body, and with the help of burner, with the help of this burner, if I am going to heat this hot body, if this body is going to be heated with the help of a burner, what you can observe? With the help of this burner, if this hot body is heated, what you observe? Tell me, what you will observe? What you will observe? Please respond, my dear students. Yes. Temperature of the object increases. Very good. Very good. The temperature of the object increases. Okay. When the temperature of this object increases, this object is going to absorb some radiation. Once again, this object is going to absorb some radiation. Here I'm going to write. So whenever a hot body is heated continuously, whenever a body is heated, whenever a body is heated continuously, what is happening? the body is going to absorb, the body is going to absorb some part of the radiation, some part of the radiation. The body is going to absorb some part of the radiation, and the body becomes heated up. So the body is going to absorb, the body is going to absorb some radiation, and the body is going to heat it up. This is our observation. Of course, this is the observation made by James Maxwell. But my dear student, whenever a body is going to be heated continuously, see here, whenever a body is going to be continuously heated, of course, it can absorb the heat as well as it can emit some radiation. So during the absorption of heat, simultaneously, there is the emission of radiation is also taking place. So not only the absorption of radiation is taking place here, not only the absorption of radiation is taking place here, what is also going to take place? Emission of radiation is also going to take place. So you can say that, you can understand that no body is going to absorb the complete radiation. Once again, no body is going to absorb the radiation completely, because when the body is going to absorb some radiation, simultaneously the body is going to emit the radiation. That means any body never completely absorbs the radiation. Once again, any body never absorbs the complete radiation, because simultaneously absorption of radiation taking place and emission of radiation is also taking place. As a result, in this universe, no body is going to absorb the complete radiation, because some part of the absorbed radiation is going to be emitted by the bodies. Whenever, if a body is there, if the body can absorb the complete radiation, then such bodies are called as perfect absorbers. Once again, if a body completely absorbs the radiation, such bodies are called as perfect absorbers. Yes, now my question is, whether any body can absorb the complete radiation? Whether any body can absorb the complete radiation? Is it possible? Yes, it is not possible. So any body present in this universe never absorbs the complete radiation, because during the absorption of radiation, what is also going to happen? Emission of radiation is also going to happen. Hence, it is impossible for a body to absorb the complete radiation. Now, coming to the point, black body. The point is now, black body. First one is about hard body. Wait a minute. Yes, the first one is about hard body. Yes, about hard body, what you can say? Hard bodies are not the perfect absorbers. If a body is not a perfect absorber, that body is not a perfect emitter. Once again, if a body is not a perfect absorber, the body is not a perfect emitter. Suppose in the universe, if any body is there which can absorb the complete energy or complete radiation and which can emit the complete radiation, such bodies are called as black bodies. Black body. Yes. Can anybody guess in the universe whether the black body is present or not? In the universe, whether the black body is present or not? Can anybody guess in the universe whether the black body is present or not? In the universe, black body is not present, because in the universe, in the universe, if any system is there, if any body is there, whenever it is going to absorb the energy, simultaneously it is going to emit the energy. So it is not possible to have a perfect absorber and perfect emitter, which was known as black body. The existence of black body, the existence of black body is not possible in this universe. This was observed by Max Planck. The scientist's name is Max Planck. So what the Max Planck observed? Maxwell. The Maxwell scientist observed that there is no perfect emitter or absorber. There is no perfect emitter or absorber of all types of radiations. Once again, my statement, there is no perfect emitter or absorber of all types of radiations. If such any body is there, such bodies are called as black bodies. It is not possible to construct a black body in this universe. This was observed by the scientist Maxwell. So finally, you can say that whenever a body is going to absorb the radiation, simultaneously the body is going to emit some other radiation. This was the observation made by Max Planck. And from this observation, Max Planck considered that any body is acting as a particle. Any body, of course, it is also a body, a duster, or a hot cup of hot coffee. Either it is a duster, suppose if it is considered as a cup of hot coffee, it is a matter. Matter is composed of particles. But we are studying about not about matter. We are not studying about matter. We are studying about electromagnetic radiations. In this class and from the previous classes, we are studying about electromagnetic radiations. We are not studying about matter. We are studying about electromagnetic radiations. And already we know that electromagnetic radiations are having wave nature. Now we are going to know that electromagnetic radiations are also having particle nature. So the wave nature of electromagnetic radiation does not explain some of the phenomena. Once again, the wave nature of electromagnetic radiation does not explain some of the phenomena. What the phenomena does not explain by wave nature of electromagnetic radiation? What are the phenomena does not explain by wave nature of electromagnetic radiation? Yes, the first phenomena. What is the phenomena does not explain by wave nature of electromagnetic radiation? The nature of emission of radiations from the hot bodies. This was not explained by wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. And the second one is ejection of electrons from metal surfaces. This was not explained by wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. And a variation of heat capacities of solids as a function of temperature. Just now we studied as a function of temperature. What we studied in this class, when a hot body is taken at two different temperatures, see this hot body taken at two different temperatures. That's what you can understand. If the hot body is taken at a temperature of T1, once again, if the hot body is taken at a temperature of T1, as the wavelength of emitted radiations are going to increase, 1000 to 2000, 2000 to 3000, as the wavelength of emitted radiations are going to increase, the intensity of emitted radiations increases, reaches to a maximum point, and then decreases. If the same hot body is taken at a temperature of T2, and what is the relation between T2 and T1? Which one is the higher temperature means? T2 is the higher temperature. T1 is the lower temperature. So if the hot body is taken at higher temperature, once again, if the hot body is taken at higher temperature, by increasing in the wavelengths, by increasing in the wavelengths of emitted radiations, again intensity of radiation is going to increase. The intensity of emitted radiation is going to increase, reaches to a maximum point and then decreases. Finally, we can understand that if the same hot body is taken at a temperature of T1, that is the lower temperature, and the same hot body is taken at a temperature of T2, that is the higher temperature, at the higher temperature, that is at T2, at the higher temperature, the maxima of the intensity of emitted radiation, this is the maxima, this is the maxima of intensity of emitted radiation, that is going to have lesser wavelength. This is the point, wavelength point. Whereas if the hot body is taken at lower temperature, this is the lower temperature. Now see this maxima of emitted radiations. The intensity of emitted radiation is having maximum point at maximum wavelength. This is the maximum wavelength. So to understand this one, yes, here I'm going to share one more screen. To understand this concept, one more screen I'm going to share here. Yes, on the screen now you can see two graphs are given on the screen. So first graph is given at a temperature of, first graph is given at a temperature of T1. Second graph is given at a temperature of T2. Once read the statements, hot body observed at temperature T1, hot body observed at a temperature T2. Yes, if you observe the maximas, maxima in the case of lower temperature and the maxima in the case of higher temperature, once again, the maxima of intensity of emitted radiations, this is the maxima of intensity of emitted radiations, the maxima of intensity of emitted radiation in the case of less temperature is present at 1500 nanometers, whereas the maxima of intensity of emitted radiations in the case of higher temperature is at 800 nanometers. Just carefully observe this one, very very important topic. Just observe carefully. Once again, the same statements. First, hot body at T1 temperature, lower temperature, the same hot body at T2 temperature, higher temperature, and we are going to consider, we are going to consider intensity of emitted radiations and wavelengths of emitted radiations. So what you can understand, whenever a hot body is present at lower temperature, the intensity of emitted radiations is maximum at higher wavelength, and if the hot body is taken at higher temperature, the intensity of emitted radiations is maximum at lower wavelengths. This is the observation made by Maxwell. From this observation, Maxwell understand that, Maxwell understood that a body, from these two points, Maxwell understood that if any body is there, the body is not going to absorb energy continuously. The body is not going to absorb the energy continuously. The body is not going to emit the energy continuously. Once again, the bodies are not going to absorb the energies continuously. The bodies are not going to emit the energy continuously. If they are not going to emit, if they are not going to absorb the energy continuously, how a body is going to absorb energy? How a body is going to emit energy? Yes. Absorption of energy or the emission of energy by the bodies is not continuous. It is discontinuous. Once again, my statement, the absorption of energy or the emission of energy by the bodies is not in a continuous manner. It is in a discontinuous manner. And whenever a body is going to emit energy, the body emits energy in small pockets. That small pockets are called as quanta. Once again, when a body is going to emit energy, that emitted energy is not continuous. and the emitted energy is not in a large quantity. The emitted energy is in a form of small quantities. That emitted energy is called as quanta. Or the absorbed energy is also not continuous. The absorbed energy is also discontinuous, and the body is going to absorb energy in small pockets. That pocket is called as quanta. So here Maxwell said that any body is going to absorb energy or emit energy in the form of small pockets and in a discontinuous manner. This is known as Planck's quantum theory. Max Planck. So according to Max Planck, emission of energy or absorption of energy taking place discontinuously in the form of small pockets, and every small pocket is called as quanta or quantum. Right, coming to one point here, whenever a body is going to emit radiation, the radiations are having some energy. Energy is indicated by E, and the energy of emitted radiation is depending upon frequency of emitted radiation. Once again, the energy of emitted radiation is depending upon frequency of emitted radiation, and the frequency is indicated by nu. And Max Planck explained the relation is energy of emitted radiation is directly proportional to frequency of emitted radiation. Energy of emitted radiation is directly proportional to frequency of emitted radiation, and the equality is written as E is equal to h nu. Already I explained this one. Capital E is equal to h nu. E means energy of either emitted radiation or absorbed radiation. Nu means frequency of either emitted radiation or absorbed radiation, and both are directly proportional with each other. This is known as Max Planck's quantum theory. My dear students, the time is very less. In the next class, I will explain the remaining thing. Yes, if you understood, please text me in the chat box as yes, understood, sir. If you didn't understood, please watch the recorded video and read the textbook. And for your doubts, please call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. excluding the holidays. If you understood the topic, please mention me in the chat box as yes, understood, sir. And please text me yes, present, sir. Thank you, students. Thank you for watching my video lectures. Please.